ਕਾਂਗਰਸ ਦੇ ਕੌਮੀ ਪ੍ਰਧਾਨ ਰਾਹੁਲ ਗਾਂਧੀ ਨੇ ਵੀਰਵਾਰ ਨੂੰ ਕੇਰਲ ਦੇ ਪ੍ਰਚਾਰ ਮੁਹਿੰਮ ਦੀ ਰਸਮੀ ਸ਼ੁਰੂਆਤ ਕੀਤੀ ਅਤੇ ਇਸ ਦੇ ਤਹਿਤ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਤ੍ਰਿਚੂਰ ਵਿੱਚ ਫਿਸਰਮੈਨ ਸੰਸਦ ਨੂੰ ਸੰਬੋਧਨ ਕੀਤਾ। ਇਸ ਮੌਕੇ ਰਾਹੁਲ ਗਾਂਧੀ ਨੇ ਪ੍ਰਧਾਨ ਮੰਤਰੀ ਨਰੇਂਦਰ ਮੋਦੀ ਤੇ ਤੰਜ ਕਸੇ ਤੇ ਕਿਹਾ ਕਿ ਪੀਐਮ ਮੋਦੀ ਦੇਸ਼ ਦੇ ਕਮਜ਼ੋਰ ਵਰਗਾਂ ਦੀ ਮਦਦ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਬਜਾਏ ਵੱਡੇ ਵੱਡੇ ਸਨਅਤਕਾਰਾਂ ਦੀ ਮਦਦ ਕਰਨ ਵਿੱਚ ਰੁਚੀ ਰੱਖਦੇ ਹਨ। ਇਸ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਹੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਮਛੁਆਰਾ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਦੇ ਵਿਅਕਤੀਆਂ ਨਾਲ ਕਈ ਮੁਸ਼ਕਲਾਂ ਦੇ ਵਿਚਾਰ ਵਟਾਂਦਰਾ ਵੀ ਕੀਤਾ।
ਸੋ ਵੀ ਹੈਵ ਡਿਸਾਈਡਿਡ ਇਨ 2019 ਵੈਨ ਵੀ ਕਮ ਟੂ ਪਾਵਰ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਟੂ ਟੇਕ ਵਨ ਔਰ ਟੂ ਬਿਗ ਡਿਸੀਜਨਸ। ਆਈ ਹੈਵ ਮੈਂਸ਼ਨਡ ਟੂ ਯੂ ਦ ਆਈਡੀਆ ਆਫ ਏ ਫਿਸ਼ਰਮੈਨ ਕਾਂਗਰਸ which will represent the fishermen in Delhi. There is another big idea that we have which we are going to do in our manifesto. And that is the idea of guaranteeing a guaranteed minimum income to all Indian citizens. So I want to explain a little bit what this guaranteed minimum income is. The government of India after 2019 will decide on a minimum income line. Certain income will be called the minimum income in India. Anybody who earns less than that minimum income line will be given money by the government of India to bring them up to the minimum income line. So we are going to basically wipe out once and for all poverty from the country. Now people say, people complain about me that I focus on and help farmers, fishermen and weaker sections, weaker people. They say that I support and help poorer people. So for example, when we forgive farmers loans in Delhi, when we forgive 70,000 crores of farmers loans, or we forgive the loans in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Rajasthan, my opponents say that I am ruining the habits of the farmers. We are creating the wrong incentive for the farmer, that they will not work because their loans will be forgiven. And my response to that argument, I want to tell you. Mr. Narendra Modi, over the last 5 years, has forgiven 3.5 lakh crore rupees of the 15 richest people in India. When Mr. Narendra Modi forgives 3.5 lakh crores of people like Anil Ambani and Nirav Modi, why do people not say that he is creating bad habits in those people? I am only arguing for fairness. I am saying, if you are going to forgive their loans, Mr. Anil Ambani's loan, then you are going to forgive the loans of fishermen and of the farmers. And if you don't want us to forgive loans of farmers, then don't forgive Mr. Anil Ambani's loan. Don't forgive Mr. Mehul Choksi's loan. Now I want to come to the jobs point that you raised. Today, if you look at our banking system, 30 to 40 people get the benefits of the entire Indian banking system. Anil Ambani got 45,000 crore rupees from the Indian banking system. He owes the Indian banks 45,000 crore rupees. Nirav Modi got 35,000 crore rupees of the Indian banking system. He owes that money to the Indian banks. Vijay Mallya, 10,000 crores. Now I want to ask you a question. How many jobs did Vijay Mallya create for India? How many jobs did Nirav Modi create for India? So the job problem is very simple. If we take the same money that was given to Nirav Modi and give it to young Indian entrepreneurs from Kerala, they will produce jobs in this country. I am confident that what Nirav Modi could not do with 35,000 crore rupees, a youngster in Kerala will do in 30 lakh rupees. Mr. Narendra Modi is the protector of Mr. Anil Ambani, of Mr. Nirav Modi, of Mr. Mehul Choksi. He is the instrument of them being allowed to capture our banking system. His friends own most of the ports in the country. They have taken your land. And all they do is Mr. Narendra Modi's marketing. It is a very simple equation. Mr. Narendra Modi is marketed by these 10 or 15 people. And Mr. Narendra Modi protects their interest and allows them to steal your money, your land.